Hello friends, good morning, myself C. Patel, and today I am going to discuss about the configurational entropy. So just entropy is the degree of randomness, as we know, inside a material. And entropy is of two types, that is vibrational or thermal entropy, and the second is configurational entropy. So basically, vibrational entropy, this entropy is associated with the atomic vibration in the material. And this vibrational entropy, the magnitude of this vibrational entropy increases as we increase the temperature and decreases as the cohesive strength of the material increases. And vibrational entropy also play a major role in many polymorphic transition, that is from one crystal structure to the another. Now, second is configurational entropy. And configurational entropy can also considered in terms of number of ways in which atoms themselves can be distributed in a space. So it comes into picture when we take more than one type of atoms and try to put them together in one place. The materials which are ordered, like the crystal NaCl, the in ordered material, the configurational entropy will be very, very low. But it will not be zero, because all the materials generally contain some defects. So some amount of configurational entropy must be present in it. And if the material is 100%, I mean there is no any defect, that is fully ordered, then the configurational entropy will be zero. But this type of material generally does not exist. Okay. Now, configurational entropy is given by K ln W, where K is Boltzmann constant and W is the number of ways in which the atoms can be arranged. For example, for a boundary solution, the number of ways of arranging atoms of one, that is A, and atom B. On further expansion, this is equal to minus R XA ln XA plus XB ln XB, where XA and XB are the mole fraction of component A and component B in the solution. This is for binary solution, and for ternary, quaternary, this will be the general equation for the delta S configuration. That is minus R summation of I equal to 1 to N XI ln XI. Okay. Delta S configuration is always positive. As we know that randomness is never negative, so there is no negative randomness, and in that case the randomness will be always positive. So in fact, entropy is always positive in the case of delta S configuration. Okay, so the delta S will be always positive, so randomness is never negative. Now come to that. This is the delta G mix, and the Gibbs free energy change upon mixing will be equal to delta H mix minus T delta S mix, and this delta S mix will be delta S configurational. For an ideal solution, this delta H mix will be equal to zero. So delta H mix can be zero, negative or positive, depending on whether there is an attractive force or repulsive force between the component A and component B. But for the ideal solution, there is no any attraction and repulsion. So in that case, the value of delta H mix will be equal to zero. So for ideal solution, the value of delta H mix will be equal to zero. Okay. One more thing about the configurational entropy is that this entropy does not bother about which element we are considering, whether it is a steel, that is iron carbon steel, or whether it is aluminium copper alloy. Configurational entropy is always the same, provided the amount of the element or the percentage of the element are same. So if we take iron with 1% carbon and aluminum with 1% copper, both will have same amount of configurational entropy. So configurational entropy does not depend on the type of metals we are going to consider here. Okay, so in the both case the configurational entropy will be same, but the amount should be same. So the composition in which they are taken will be same. So in that case the configurational entropy will be the same. Now, so delta S configurational for a perfect crystal will be very very low, and if it fully perfect then it will be equal to zero. But it is not possible to have fully perfect, because even in ordered material there should be some disorder inside it, and that is called partially ordered material. Okay. Now let's solve the questions that had been asked in gate exam from this particular topic. So the first question is, configurational entropy due to ideal mixing in a binary AB system is expressed as delta S mix equal to minus R XA ln XA plus XB ln XB, where XA and XB are the mole fraction of A and B. So delta S mix is maximum at XA equal to how much? So if you want to find the delta S maximum, so in that case D of del S mix upon D of XA will be equal to zero. Okay, for maximum this condition should be satisfied here, where del S mix is equal to minus R XA ln XA plus XB ln XB. So now we have to just convert XB in terms of XA, and we know that XA plus XB, that is the mole fraction of both of them, will be equal to 1. So in that case we can replace XB as 1 minus XA, so it will be equal to minus R XA ln XA minus R ln 1 minus XA plus R XA ln 1 minus XA. That will be the final result of this. Now we have to just simplify this. So D of del S mix upon D of XA should be equal to 0, and that will be equal to, in that case if we differentiate this term, okay, so this will be equal to minus R into XA into 1 upon XA minus R ln XA minus R 1 upon XA into minus 1 plus R ln 1 minus XA minus R XA 1 minus XA. That should be equal to 0. If we'll take the R at the common, then the answer will be, this will be cancelled out, minus 1 minus ln XA minus minus plus will be there, 1 upon 1 minus XA will be equal to XB plus ln 1 minus XA will be equal to XB minus R XA, and 1 minus XA will be equal to XB. This R will be cancelled out because we have taken R as common. So in that case minus 1 of minus 1 ln XA plus 1 upon XB plus ln XB by minus XA divided by XB equal to 0. So just we simplify it, 1 minus ln xa plus ln xb, and these both will be equal to 1 minus xa divided by xb equal to 0, and this is also 1 minus xa is equal to xb, so this will be equal to 1, and this minus 1 and 1 will be cancelled out, and it will be equal to ln xa equal to ln xb, and in this case xb will be equal to xb. So the mole fraction of a and b should be equal, so in that case xa plus xb equal to 1, and solving these two, xa will be equal to 0.5 and xb will be equal to also 0.5. So for the delta x mix, it's maximum when xa and xb equal to 0.5, so the mole fraction will be 0.5 for a as well as b, so the number of atom of a and b will be equal. In that case the delta s configuration will be the maximum. Now let's solve the second one. This question has been asked in GATE 2011, and the question is, 1 mole of P is mixed with 1 mole of element Q. The entropy of mixing at 0 Kelvin temperature is. So we know that delta S configuration is equal to minus R X A ln X A plus X B ln X B, and in that case minus R, this will be P and Q, so XP ln XP plus XQ ln XQ, and mole of P is equal to 1 mole and mole of Q is also equal to 1 mole. In that case mole fraction of P is 1/2 and mole fraction of Q is also 1/2, so if we put the value, minus R 1/2 ln 1/2 plus 1/2 ln 1/2, and if we simplify it, it will be equal to minus R ln 0.5. so this will be the correct answer in this case. So that's the end of the lecture. Thank you very much.